Good morning, guys. So the topic for today's discussion is quorum rules. So in this chapter, I have dealt with the topics like the importance of aquatic ecosystem, the lake ecology, eutrophication, the wetlands, harmful algal blooms, estuary, and the mangroves. So the leftover topics is only coral reefs. So these are the things which are dealt with the aquatic guys. Okay. So means the with respect to the water. Okay. So now our topic for today's discussion is coral reefs. Coral reefs. Okay. So what do you mean by coral reefs? Okay. What are corals? So if you see, so corals are the living animals. Corals are the living animals. And these are having the symbiotic association with the zooxanthellae. So what do you mean by zooxanthellae, guys? Zooxanthellae is nothing but the microscopic algae. Don't confuse with the zoo word. Okay. Zooxanthellae. Zooxanthellae, don't confuse with the zoo and don't think it is animal. Zooxanthellae is microscopic algae. Okay. So corals are the living animals which has the symbiotic relation with the zooxanthellae. That is the microscopic algae. Okay. So microscopic algae means it is plants. Okay. So the microscopic algae. So how these are having the symbiotic relations? So about symbiotic relations, we have done this in the our previous chapter, guys. Okay. So symbiotic relation is nothing but the both organisms are getting benefited. So how these both organisms are getting benefited? So these zooxanthellae, that is the microscopic algae, provide energy as nutrient to the corals, okay, to the animals. So in return, the corals are protecting or giving shelter to this algae. Okay, guys. So this is the symbiotic relation between these two species. So but the corals are, that we can say, the zooxanthellae lives on the coral base. So why these lives on the coral instead of the ground? Because so this has to prepare the food. So to prepare food, they require the photosynthesis. So they can get the photosynthesis at the top level, guys. Means if there is no interface between the sun and the organism present which requires, okay, which requires the sunlight, so then they get good amount of the sunlight and they can prepare the food through the photosynthesis process. That's why these zooxanthellae life are present on the coral. Okay. So guys, clear? If you take the coral like this and the zooxanthellae present on this, so that if you can directly sunlight from the sun, okay, and prepare food, okay, and provide to the corals. Okay. So this is about the corals, guys. So I think I have clearly mentioned what are corals. Now the corals are the living organism which have a symbiotic relationship with the zooxanthellae, that is the microscopic living organism. This zooxanthellae present on the coral reefs such that they get the required amount of sunlight to prepare the food through photosynthesis process. Okay. So instead of the land or ground, they present on the these reefs. Okay. So these will provide the nutrients or the energy or the carbon to the corals. So in return, coral provides shelter or the protection to the algae. Okay. So fine, guys. So this is about the corals. So and depending upon the tissues of the zooxanthellae, that is the microscopic algae, the coral will be having its different color, guys. Okay. So the coral, corals will be the white in color. So depend upon the pigment of the algae. So the pigment is the one which is color, guys. So depending upon the pigment of the algae, the coral also take the same color. Okay. Clear? Okay, guys. So this is how the corals and the algae are having the symbiotic relationship with each other. Okay. So after this, if you see the types of corals, we have two types of coral, guys. Okay, two types of coral. That is, we have a hard coral and soft coral. So a hard coral is the one which build the reefs. Which build the reefs. Reefs are called as the hard coral. Don't confuse with each and every term, guys. So you should have clear conceptual clarity. What you mean by corals? Now I am going. Now I am slowly taking to your coral reefs. So corals are of two types. That is soft coral and the hard coral. So a hard coral are the one which build the reefs are called as the hard corals. Okay. So depending upon these, so hard corals, the builders are the tiny animals. Okay, the builders are the tiny animals called as propels. Okay, so depending upon the builders of the reefs are called as the tiny animals, that is propel. Okay, right. So this will thrive, lay and die, guys. Okay, this will thrive, grow and die and leave behind the limestone. Okay, or we can say that lime is called calcium carbonate. So those form as the solid or the form, so that will protect the corals. Okay, guys. So I repeat, guys. So corals have been divided into two types, that is the soft and the hard. So a hard one is called as the is the one which builds the reefs. Okay, the builders of the reefs are called as the polyps. These are the small tiny animals. Okay, so these are the one which thrive, grow and eventually it will die, leaving behind the lime. Okay, leaving behind the lime. So the lime is called calcium carbonate. That is a hard substance there to protect the corals present in that area. Okay, so if there is having the corals, they form the calcium carbonate. Okay, or the lime. This will protect the corals. This is about the hard corals. So these are present at the tropical and subtropical regions of the depth regions of the colder areas, guys. So in the depth regions of the colder areas, okay, in the water, guys. Clear? Now we are going to see the features of the coral reefs. Okay, features. If you see the features of the coral reefs, so coral reefs are also, so generally the coral reefs present at the shallow region, guys. Okay, shallow. Okay, shallow regions of the tropics. Shallow regions of the tropics, that is the approximately 30 degrees, guys. So at the 30 degrees north and south, these corals are present. So the characteristics are clean, clear and warm. So the water present at that place should be clean, clear and the warm, guys. Very, very important. So the whatever the things that are uttering from your mouth, very, very important points, guys. So they will ask these. And they will change the it should be cold water, it should be the water which is not clear, okay, and that is the dirty water. They will ask like questions like this. So the conditions are the clean, clear and the warm, guys. Okay, so in the aquatic system we have around 19,000 of square kilometers, guys. Okay, 19,000 kilometers we are having the square kilometers, sorry, 19,000 square kilometers we are having the coral reefs. Okay, so coral reefs are the one which have the nutrients, guys. So even though the coral reefs form their places at the less nutrient places, or the means, even though if the corals are present at the place where they are having the less nutrients, they have the ability to recycle, guys. So again, through the process of recycling, they will get the required amount of the nutrients, guys. Okay. So, and the process of the growing of the algae is very fast, whereas the coral is very slow, guys. Okay, so coral will grow slowly, means they form the lime or the calcium carbonate very slowly over the corals, but the algae present over there will be very fast. Okay, so these are the features of the coral reefs. Okay guys, fine, clear? So after this, now I am going to take concept guys. So this is the, so the corals are called as the tropical rainforest of the ocean. So few concepts like this we can get guys. Like the ship is called, like the camel is called the ship of the desert. Why the camel is called the ship of the desert? Because the camel plays such a role in the desert guys. Such a role in the desert. For that reason also, same here, the corals are called the tropical rainforest of the oceans. Why? Because, so the vertebrates, invertebrates and the plants live in close association with the corals guys. So in close association with the corals, and these have the again in return the biological coupling guys, sorry, the resource coupling and the nutrient cycle guys. So these one which are having close association with the corals have the resource coupling. So they couple the resources everyone and have the nutrient recycling such that so the productivity increases and the biological activity and the biodiversity will be more at that place. For these reasons, the corals are called as the tropical rainforest of the oceans. Okay guys, clear? So the plants, vertebrates, invertebrates live in close association with the coral reefs. Okay, that is one point guys. Okay, and they have the resource coupling and nutrient recycling capabilities simultaneously. Okay, this is the one more point. And such that the productivity increases and the biodiversity also increases. So you should remember the things in the point wise guys, such that it will make you useful. Like I explained now guys. Okay. So this should be remembered and this should be present in your papers. Okay. For this reason it is called as the tropical rainforest of the ocean guys. Okay. So now after this I am going to move to the classification of the corals. Classification. If you see the classification, so they have the four types guys. That is the fringe coral, okay, patches, okay, and we have fringe patches, okay, atoll and barrier. So these are the four type of corals that are present guys. So what do we mean by fringe corals? So fringe corals are nothing but they have contiguous corals through the shoreline. Okay, contiguous. So like this guys. So through the shoreline, they have the contiguous coastal shoreline. These are called as the fringes. So the examples of fringes are the Andaman and the Nicobar. Okay, Andaman and Nicobar. So these are the places where the fringe corals are present. And you see the patches. So patches are the like we can say the separate guys. So separated discontinuous places. Like so we have some corals here, some corals here, some plus one. Okay. And the discontinuous. Okay. Patches. So these are called the patches guys. And the places where the patches are found are we have the Gulf of Kutch. The Gulf of Mannar and so Gulf of Mannar and we have Park Bay. So these are the places where the corals are present, the unattached or discontinuous patches. These atolls are the semicircular guys, semicircular ones which are brought from the seawater. So which we get from the seawater guys, seawater atolls. Okay, are this semicircular or the circular corals. Okay, so the places where these are found at Nicobar and Lakshadweep. Okay, after this we have the barrier. So barriers are the parallels to the shorelines. So for example, if you have shore guys, okay, shoreline and the reef over here, reef. So the place between the shore and the reef is called as the lagoon guys. Okay, it is called as the lagoon. Okay, it is called as the lagoon. Okay, so these are the barriers on the one which are present at the parallel to the shorelines. Okay, and these are also places at the Nicobar and the Lakshadweep islands. So these are about the types of corals we have found. So after that, now we will see to the functions of the corals. So what are the functions of the corals? If you see the functions of the coral, the first and foremost functions of the coral, that is functions. Okay, so these are the one which restrict or which are very important during the storms and the and prevent it from the erosion phase. Okay, so during the storms and erosion. Okay, so these act as the barrier phase. Okay, during the storms and the erosion. So and the erosion not takes place, guys. Okay. This is the first function, and second one is, so with this the animals will get the plankton size. So required number of plankton will be get by the animals. Okay, plankton. Okay, so and the third one we have animal habitat. So the reason of that place will be good habitat for the animals, guys. Okay, and the animals will get the plankton for their survival. Okay, so these are the few usefulness or the few functions of the ecosystem and the corals, and these will provide the health of the ecosystem. Okay, so corals will provide the health of the water, guys. Okay, so these are the functions of the corals. Now if you see a threat to the corals, so the threat may be of two types here, that is the natural or the man-made. So the natural threat is the simplification of coral bleaching. Okay guys, so bleaching of the corals means the removal of the protection layer and leaving behind the only the white tissue. Okay, is known as the coral bleaching. Okay, so the natural process is the coral bleaching, and the through man-made we can say that, so because of the chemicals or the phosmotics that we are releasing in the water, so due to this the corals are bleached, guys. Okay, and after that we have dredging. So dredging is nothing but the removal of the land, the places where the ship travels is known as the dredging. So the removal of the lower land, okay, the lower soil in the aquatic ecosystem is called as dredging, guys. And these are the true anthropogenic activities. These are the about the threats to the corals. Okay, so now we will see what is coral bleaching. As I said, in the threats, the naturally we have the coral bleaching. So we will see the what is meant by coral bleaching. Okay, coral bleaching is the nothing but, so the stress that is making the corals to bleach. So it's simple, guys. If anyone is having this stress, their state of living, their conditions means their habitat will differ, guys. Even in human beings also, same happens with the coral bleaching. So the first and topmost reason is stress. So the stress that the corals will get make them to bleach. Bleaching is nothing but the removal of the pigment or the removal of the color of the corals. Okay guys, okay, it should be the washed away because of the stress that is disturbing the corals and leaving behind the only carbonate, calcium carbonate, that is the white tissue. Okay, so the problem is the stress. So what happened? So when the coral will be bleached? So the coral will be bleached when the algae, that is the zooxanthellae density, will decrease. So if the zooxanthellae density will decrease, the corals can't get the required amount of the energy or the nutrients. So if the density of the decrease, then they will lead to the bleaching, guys. Okay, so if it takes approximately 60 to 90% So if approximately 60 to 90% of the algae decrease, then it will form the bleaching guys. Okay, so after that, so even though if the algae has decreased, then to some extent it will be fine guys. If the pigment present in the algae, that is lost, means if that is lost approximately around 50 to 80% of the pigment, then the coral will be, then the coral will become stuck. So same thing as human beings also guys. So if you are not able to get the food, 3 times or the required number of friends will become stressed guys. Okay. So in the same manner, if it is, if the corals are not finding the algae of 60 to 90%, it will be bleached. Or if the pigment is not found around 58%, then it will be also bleached. Okay. So in this manner, they will become stressed guys. Okay. Okay. And the reason, so on the coral bleaching, the, for the other reasons also, they won't get the nutrients. Okay, they won't get the required amount of nutrients. So these will make them the bleaching eggs. Okay, and the aquatic conditions, and the, so along with these and the external factors also play an important role in bleaching. External factors, that is the one which are present at the places. Okay, so these are the about coral bleaching. Now we will see causes of the coral bleaching. Okay, causes. So causes of the coral bleaching, if you say the temperature. Temperature. Why? Because it said that the during the futures it should be warm, clean and clear. If the temperature is so high, that is due to the industrial waste water, if the temperature becomes very high, then the habitat for the coral will be difficult guys. So the temperature plays a very important role. And second one, subaerial. Subaerial. So the coral present in the water guys. So if the water is not present, so by the one way or the other way, if the water is lost at that place, then it will be exposed to the subaerial. Okay, that, so in such a manner, so these are also possible to the coral, that is the exposure to light. Okay, and after this we have sedimentation. So if the rivers or the streams which flows that will brought the sedimentation, that silt or slate, and they will dump at the places where they are coral present, this also will affect the conditions of the corals. So these are also the few causes of the corals. Okay, and the also on the pathogens. Okay guys, so on the pathogens, that is the external factors. Okay, that is protozoa. So the pathogens, if attack the corals, that will also affect the corals. The example is protozoa guys. Okay, and after we have irradiation. Okay, irradiation also will affect the corals. Irradiation. So these are the few causes of the coral reefs. So with this I am completing this session guys, that is coral reefs. So guys, we are done with the aquatic system. Okay, if you have any queries, please feel free to ask me. Okay guys, clear? So with this we are done with the chapter number 4. So in the ecology part we are left with 2 chapters, that is the renewable energy and the pollutants, that I am going to take in a few days. So in this week I will complete these 2 topics, and such that we will complete the topics of in the ecology, and we move to the next stream, that is the biodiversity and climate change. Okay guys, so clear? Okay, so these are the important topics in this chapter, that is the wetlands, eutrophication, estuary, mangroves and the coral reefs. These are the one which gives good weightage to your every examination. So thank you one and all.